Before Snoop Dogg, Biggie and Pac, it was Mac Dre and he ran with the rhyme. We was California living, the Bay was home. And that was way back before he 40 was on. It was Too Short, bitch, that was all we knocked. Met Ray Love when he was rocking with Pac. Mac Maul was a youngster, still on the couch. And Dre was just talking about putting him out. We had just lost the Mac, the hood was itchy. 415 knocking Oak and Richie. Mike Fish went to jail, so the blow was slow. We had to fuck with Richmond niggas or go to the O. Sonny ran Richmond and fuck with the V. And when Fish went to jail, he started fucking with me. Sonny knocked Shonda and the bitch was cool. And Shonda used to push Sonny whips to school. Sonny had funk with One Eye Mar. They found Sonny dead laying right by his car. That was way back, we was still at the high. Elijah had the South, but S was the guy. The East and the West had to get it from S. The North was all mine, he would enter the crest. See, Brill and Baby Narc, they wanted S dead. And me and Narc fought cause they was on S head. But that's precious, so we let that slide. And we had other shit to think about, the Mac just died. Life is too short, the game is thick. Mr. Flamboyant, then came the click. Sugar D shot E-40 legit, but it was Lil' Bruce Thurman who started the shit. Bruce was a hitter, I would have to say. First he hit the Mac, then he hit Mac Dre. Dre went posto and came with a slapper. Introduced a classic called Coco Capper. A rap war started in the heart of the Bay. And all they talk about is E-40 and Dre. D'Angelo was Deacon, Freak was Dion. Con went to YA for killing the peon. The first rhyme murder, he had shot a nigga dead. D was 15 when he shot him in the head. Damn, I still remember that night. And they gave the Cuddy juvenile life. We on color kill, no blood or crippin'. Shit got real cause our hoods was trippin'. A couple years later, we was ballin' ridiculously. Vallejo got a visit from Unsolved Mysteries. Banks being robbed and all the shit. A Brinks truck got hit and guards was killed. Vallejo was on fire, the head of the news. And whoever was behind it, they was scared of them dudes. Cavi was the first to get caught on the lick. He had a high speed chase and shot it out on the bridge. Word on the streets, it's them romper room kids. Khalid caught a case and got 33 years. That's the first lead, it was out of the blue. And when Cavi went to jail, they got right on my crew. They started rassing us while we was running the streets. So Dre made a song called Punk Police. He hit Detective Nickelman and Officer Ritz. They sent Corey Dunn on some officer shit. Corey was a car thief who stole my whips. I used to use Corey cars in all my licks. Corey caught a case not pertaining to me. Corey couldn't do his time, instead he gave me. I had planned a lick down in Fresno City. I needed G-Ride, so I took him with. It was me, Mac, Dre, Kilo, and Corey. But Dre was never supposed to be part of the story. See, Dre never hit licks, he was the rapper. And caught a bad break cause his crew was jackers. Dre had a choice to ride or cop out. He kept his mouth closed and did five in line pop. Cuddy Buzz was dying, we trying to savage the sale. So he recorded the first rap album from jail. It was over the phone and it had never been done. Not to mention he made one hell of a song. But Dre was out of the loop, so he made the Mac call. Told Kyrie to get a ball to Mac Maul. Maul had the sets and that was the new romp. His first video was produced by Tupac. Young players gotta get it together. My little nigga was on and he was getting his cheddar. A young Crest Cuddy came straight from the gutter. He turned Strictly Business Records into Young Black Brother. In 96, Dre released and bounced out. And word on the streets, they releasing the romp out. Con came home, hooked up with Dre. They dropped the Rompilation 1 and that shook the bank. Kilo did 8 and got back to Dre. I had 2 years left, but I was on my way. My crew was on course and shit was looking good. The feds came through and overtook my hood. It was deja vu, they got back on my crew. The coldest thing about it, they got Deacon too. He went right back. After doing his 10, he had 2 years home and had to do it again. Damn. Lost a couple niggas we thought was real. Artie and Marcel, they both had squealed. They flipped on Deacon, now that was shady. G went to trial and they gave him 80. He had 2 years out since the age of 15. He was 27 then and never see the streets again. That was something cold, man, we felt that blow. It's more to the story, I'm just letting you know. The romper room name was turning to shit. So Dre flipped the game and changed the thiz. I'ma state it for the record, if y'all ain't heard, Miami, the most made up that word. Coolio was home and Ray was coming. And somehow Dre and Ray went through something. Mac Dre and Mac Maul fell out too. And I'm sitting in my cell like, what the hell do I do? My hood splitting up, boss is gone, but I'ma make shit right again once I'm home. I threw a boat cruise, made my dudes attend, and by the time the boat docked, we was a crew again. But we was missing some people, Ronnie Wags and Jay Smith. Not coming home, but Khalid won't make it. The birth of the nation, and Dre was the start. And I'm waiting patient and playing my part. The Cudi on his shit, and they liking the style. Plus he rocking shows, and I'm hyping his crowd. And he knocking hoes, and I'm watching them get him. And before you know, I was knocking them with him. Played the game like a crew, that's what we do. The Cudi bought a range, and I bought one too. Dre was back on, and I was rocking the rear. 2003, and that was the year. It is what it is, we's coming to fuck up. Back then, we used to fuck with Yuck Tough. Back then, we used to fuck with Bart. But Bart was a rat, so we cut him short. Then Trill Television jumped out in the streets. And Mac Dre, all he talking about in the streets. Then Dre had a show out in KC Mo. My P.O. was tripping, wouldn't let me go. He caught Dre slipping, and I'll never forget. The morning Kilo called and said Dre was hit. Shit, the evil that men do. To be continued.
Rest in peace, Cudi.